Hi everybody, John Riddle here with a short tutorial today on Microsoft Visio, great tool for creating things like diagrams, schematics. You can even do 2D CAD floor plans with it. It's available either through a subscription or you can get it on a perpetual license. Now in just a few minutes, I'm going to go over the basics on how to use Visio Standard and Professional for Windows computers. But these basics are also applicable for the Visio online version, which can be used by macOS users. So settle back, relax, and let's get this started. As you open Visio, the startup page shows up with several options, such as browsing for your most recent projects or other files with Open. To see how to use Visio, let's start from scratch with blank drawing, selecting the right units between metric and U.S. Imperial. The new document opens on the main interface, showing the ribbon bar at the top with several drawing tools. The Shapes panel on the left and the big preview where you draw and edit shapes. At the bottom, check the pages of your document, adding new ones with the plus button. If you prefer working in a dark theme, go to File, Options, General, and change the office theme. If you plan to print or export your document, you may have to configure your page properties from Design, Page Setup. Here, set the page orientation to Portrait or Landscape, and choose the standard page size from the available options. Open the Page Setup dialog to define a custom page size, or let Visio automatically extend the page if any object goes beyond its borders. Switch to Page Properties to set the measurement unit, such as millimeters, centimeters, inches, or others. Go to Design Backgrounds to add a page background that includes colors, borders, or titles. These are all saved within a special page called V Background, which is taken as reference for all the other pages of your document. Now let's see how to draw in Visio. You can drop three main types of objects: shapes, connectors to link these shapes, and text to add annotations and labels. To draw shapes, go to Home and enable any drawing tool. Click and drag to drop rectangles, ellipses, lines, arcs, or free shapes. Holding down the Shift key to align in specific directions and using the Escape key to cancel the current drawing. You can also use the Freeform tool to draw freehand, using the blue nodes to refine the shape. Switch to the Draw tab to draw freehand with pens or highlighters, adjusting trace color and thickness at the top. Enable Stroke Eraser to remove any drawing by clicking over these. Visio also provides a vast library of ready-to-use shapes within collections called Stencils that you can find in the Shapes panel on the left, browsing within More Shapes. To import any shape, drag and drop it onto your document. You can zoom in or out on the preview using the mouse wheel while holding down the Control key. Visio also provides several visual aids from the View tab at the top. Enable rulers to get measurements on the page, grids to align objects, and page breaks to get margins from the page borders if you print. Enable guides to click and drag from the rulers to follow horizontal and vertical directions more easily. Visio also offers several snapping options to specific object points, curves, or the page grid itself, depending on the settings under View Visual Aids. You can temporarily disable any snapping by holding down the Alt key. Now let's see how to work with connectors. From home, enable the connector tool and click and drag from one shape to another to create a wire that links them. Shapes show anchors called connector points to which wires get attached. These also vary depending on the shape. Custom shapes do not have connector points, so connectors may not work properly. To add points, select the shape with the pointer tool and then enable connection point. Hold down the control key and click to drop new connector points on the shape path or outside of it. You can also click and drag any anchor to move it. Once done, switch to the connector tool to drop the wires you need. Now, let's see how to edit connectors and shapes with the pointer tool. Click on any wire to select it, drag its endpoints to change the connection, and right-click on it to change its type. Choose straight connector for straight lines. Right-angle connector for wires with 90-degree angles that you can reshape with the blue nodes, and curve connector for curved wires using the blue handles to fine-tune any curve. On shapes, click on any object to select it and use its nodes to rotate or resize it. Drag the object to move it, following guides and snapping options set. You can also hold down the Shift key to move horizontally or vertically. When you move any object connected with wires, these connectors follow and get updated automatically. This may not work if the wire is not attached to a connector point. Right-click to cut, copy, or paste any object, and use Ctrl and Z to undo any action. To add annotations or titles, enable the Text tool and click and drag on the page to drop a text box where you can type within its boundaries. From the Home tab, set Font Family, Size, Style, Color, and Alignment. These changes affect the entire text box content, unless you select any specific part of the text from it. Text boxes are indeed independent shapes that you can move, scale, and rotate freely. You can also add connector points and link text boxes to other shapes. If you want to attach text to objects, enable the Text tool, click on any shape path, and type in. This way, text remains within such shape, adjusted when you move or edit it. You can adjust the text properties from the Home tab. In the same way, you can attach text to connectors. When selecting with the pointer tool, you can use the yellow node to place text correctly. If you get objects that overlap, select any object and adjust the order from Home, Arrange. You can also select multiple objects to move, rotate, and scale these together. Just hold down the Control key and click on each object to select each of them. To avoid selecting every time, right-click and go to Group to combine objects into a single group to select and edit faster. You can also edit the single components of this group by clicking once within it. To separate objects again, right-click on the group and select Ungroup. Now let's see how to customize any object appearance. You can open the Design tab and apply a general theme to your entire project. You can also select any object and go to Home, Shape Styles to adjust fill color, line color, thickness, style, and endpoints type. You can also apply shadows or any glow effect if you like. For the complete set of properties, right-click on the object and go to Format Shape to open a more detailed panel on the right side. You can save your own drawings within Stencils for future use. To create your own stencil, go to the Shapes panel on the left and go to More Shapes, New Stencil. Right-click on it and go to Save As to save it with proper name as a VSSX file format. At this point, just drag and drop any shape or group into the stencil, saving their appearance, connection points, wires, and any text applied. In any future project, you can browse for the stencil from More Shapes, Open Stencil, and import any shape by dragging and dropping it into the document. At the top, open the Insert tab to import pictures, icons, charts, or CAD drawings. Click on Pictures to browse for any image, using the pointer tool to move, rotate, or scale it. From the Picture Format tab, apply color corrections, add borders, or crop the image as you need. You can also right-click on the picture and go to Format Shape to get the full list of properties. To save your Visio document, go to File, Save As, getting a VSDX file format that you can reopen and edit in the future. Whereas, to print your document, go to File, Print. On the left side, set the number of copies, which pages to print, and adjust page orientation, paper size, and color. To export your document as an image, select the right page and go to File, Save As. Select the correct file format, such as SVG, to export a vector-based image for the web, DWG to export and use in CAD software, or EMF, JPEG, or PNG to export as an image rendered in pixels. If you want to preserve transparency, select PNG, and in the Export dialog, enable the Transparency Color option, selecting the color matching your page background. By default, the entire document page is exported unless you select any specific object or group while you save. If you're not tied to page standards, make sure to go to Design, Size, Fit to Drawing to fit the page dimensions with your drawings in order to get the best quality when you export as an image. Hey, thank you very much for watching today's tutorial on Microsoft Visio for 2025. We hope you found it very useful and learned something new that you didn't know about it already. And if you want to learn more about many other softwares and tools you can use to enhance your everyday life and your drawings, just go to our YouTube channel or our website. And we'll see you next time.